And here's Boyle, who sets it up for Pavelski with a drive. Save made by Luongo. Boyle dumped it to the front. Redirected. Good stop there by Luongo. His best of the first period here in game four. Big hit on Murray.
And there he is, number three. He has his head down. Here comes Rafi Torres. And Torres definitely had some momentum. But he could tell right away he was getting a penalty. Murray with his head down. Boom. Here comes McGinn on the forecheck, and Ballard just ducks down. Oh, yeah, that's a beauty.
Well, yeah, but nobody's playing the puck. You know, puck's right there. McGinn's going towards it. The one thing that Ballard has throughout his career is warned by the National Hockey League about how low he gets that hip check.
It was a minute 55 of a 5-on-3 that the Canucks failed to score on in the second period of game three. Let's see what they do here. Straight away, Salo didn't one time at far side, and one time a score! No mistake on that one for Ryan Kessler. He gets the first goal of game four. It's 1-0 Canucks.
Well, this is the perfect setup, and what a one-timer it is. Vancouver tried to go through the three players in game three. They don't. They go around the outside and get it set up for the perfect one-timer. You can see there's no room down the middle, but Kessler backs away into the face-off circle. Nice one-time pass, perfect position from Salo, and Kessler hammers it.
And the way that Murray went down on the first one, he kind of bit on a potential shot, and that left a weak side wide open.
Henrik Sedin again. It's Burrows that's setting up shop in front of Niemi. Daniel to Henrik. Takes a look across, waits, sets it up on the one-timer by Salo. Score! Bounced off of somebody in front. But it will be the second 5-on-3 goal of this second period, and Vancouver has a 2-0 lead.
Here's the adjustment again, and Salo has got a terrific shot. But watch Henrik Sedin. He has the puck, and you'll watch how tightly together, and for good reason, the three San Jose Shark defenders are. There was no room down the middle. Look at Sedin, takes a look in the middle. Look at those three guys in black. Look at Salo at the top. Boom. He's got the heavy shot. Niemi got a piece of it, but not enough.
And again, the Vancouver Canucks are really exploiting or going towards the blocker side there of Niemi. The shot by Kessler was a heck of a shot on the one-timer blocker side. This one went right through the arm.
Yeah, they got a delay of game on Douglas Murray, so it's another 5-on-3. And here is Henrik Sedin looking right in front for a one-timer score! And I believe that'll be Salo's again. It is 3-0 Canucks.
Well, he just walks into this one and just hammers it. San Jose is the team in disarray. They're making way too many mistakes. You can't keep giving up 5-on-3 situations when you have this kind of talent. Control off the faceoff again, and that is key. They get it back. San Jose is in trouble. You want Sedin, the guy, the best setup man with the puck. And he'll get it back to the point. Watch this, an absolute stride into the puck. That's like practice. And Salo hammers that one home.
Henrik Sedin, who had three assists in that second period. Off the center, it's a 2-on-1 here. Henrik Sedin and Burrows. Henrik Wake. Back into the front, they score! What a pass! He put it through the legs of Niemi, right to the blue paint, and Burrows had the tap in.
When your star players start feeling it like this, there's no limit to what they can do. A little bit of luck here from Henrik Sedin. And I can't help but think that Niemi had to be reading this one a lot better. Henrik Sedin doesn't like to shoot. He should have been shooting this puck. He's a left-hand shot on the right-wing side. He fakes it and he fakes it. It's well played by Boyle. Boyle had taken the pass away. That is not on Boyle. That is all on Antti Niemi.
I haven't seen too many plays like that where you can feather a pass between the goalies.
Vancouver Canucks are going to take a commanding 3-1 lead in the Western Conference Final. Back to their home ice when this resumes, and Klo with a glove into the face. Well, the Vancouver player, is that Kessler that he knocked down with the left glove?
Yeah, I believe it is Kessler. Kessler still down on the ice. He got pushed over backwards and punched in the face, if you will. Here's the closing seconds of the game. Kessler 17 white and then Klo 29 in black. Keep an eye out. This is after the whistle. Boom. Oh, he pops him one all right. Little quick uppercut with the left hand.
Vancouver Canucks congratulating their winning goaltender, Roberto Luongo.
Sammy, have you ever won a hockey game of this significance, only getting 13 shots on goal?
No, not the, as far as I can remember. I haven't, but, you know, Roberto made some big saves, and obviously our penalty kill stepped up tonight big time.
Funny ebb and flow to this game where they get five straight power plays. How are you able to maintain your composure as a team?
Well, we knew coming into the tonight's game that they were going to come hard, and that's what they did, and we ended up taking some unnecessary penalties, but we knew if we were going to kill those penalties, we were going to get our chances and some calls our way, and that's what happened.
You've got a terrific shot. Everybody knows that. In game number three, you didn't get that many opportunities through. In this one, you did. What was the difference between game three and game four?
Well, we obviously got some looks in the last game on the 5-on-3, and we did on video, and the main thing was to get the shots through, and that's what ended up happening tonight.
Henrik had a heck of a game.
Awesome. You know, when he had the puck on his stick, just find an open space.
Thanks very much for doing this.
Thanks.
Well, thanks very much. Thanks for coming out here. I know it's a little difficult coming back out onto the ice, but four helpers in this game, it ties a Vancouver playoff record. But tell us a little bit about how that power play changed for you guys in the second period.
Yeah, I mean, after our last game, we had a really solid 5-on-3 where we just couldn't score on the chances we had. And we got some good looks today. And for me, it's just picking and choosing who's going to shoot the puck. And today, Sam was open a couple of times, and he did a great job.
Is it about buying time and then looking people off? I mean, for a guy like Salo, who's got such a hard shot, from our point of view anyway, to find him wide open like that was pretty surprising.
Yeah, but the way Danny goes through there to the far post, I mean, the last game he had an empty netter and weren't able to score, but today they took him away and they opened up Sammy.
One quick question, was that a pass or was that to be a shot on goal?
I won't tell you.
Thank you, buddy.
That was a shot.
Thanks.
Never give away your secrets.